I welcome Dr. Sudhanshu Sharma from IGNOU SOCIS as an expert for this session on introduction to mobile hardware.
Thank you, Fauzia. Mobile hardwares are in fact very different from the custom hardware for the normal computer systems, because they are supposed to work in an environment where high amount of communication is required. Apart from this, they are supposed to work with different type of processors. In computer systems, we are having CISC computing, that is complex instruction set computing. And so far as our mobile systems are there, we are having reduced instruction set computing. So, computing environment is very different. Apart from this, ARM processors in the mobile operating systems and x86 processors in the computer systems. So, that means the operating system environment is very different. So, accordingly, and processors are very different, instruction set computing environment is very different. So, as a result of which, the mobile hardwares are supposed to be very different from your normal computer system hardwares.
We would like to understand, how are the requirements of mobile hardware different from the requirements of laptop or desktop?
Yeah, this is a very good question, Fauzia. Actually, the working of laptops and desktops is very different from that of the mobiles, because laptops and desktops are quite stationary, they are stable, but mobile systems are having a flavor of mobility. Now, because they are stable, the laptops and desktops are stable, they are enjoying the environment of complex computations, but lesser communication. But mobile devices are supposed to go for more communication, as a result of which the computation part is reduced. So, that is why the hardware requirement for mobiles are very different from that of the computers. Likewise, the processors in a normal computer is of x86 configurations, but in that of mobiles, we are having ARM processors. Further, instruction set computing is concerned, in mobiles we are having RISC, that is reduced instruction set computing, but in normal computers we are having CISC, that is complex instruction set computing. Apart from this, the communication is more in mobiles and communication is quite less in comparison of mobiles in your normal computers. So, that is why the hardware requirements of mobiles are very different from that of the normal computers. But one more thing is to be observed, that the battery usage is to be minimized in mobile devices, because we are having say 4000 mAh or 2000 mAh of the battery, and if the hardware is consuming more battery, then the mobile will become less operational. So, as a result of which, the mobile hardwares are supposed to consume less power, and but that of the normal laptops or computers, they may go for high power consumptions also. So, this is a fundamental difference in between your computer hardware and the mobile hardware. We may go for computer architectures. In the normal computer, in the desktop computer, we are having Intel AMD processors. Secondly, so far as memory is concerned, in your computers, we are having a requirement of disk memory, but no disk memory is available in your mobile operating system. Apart from this, the real-time operating system is required in your mobile systems, because at runtime, the data is to be communicated. So, operating system is supposed to work in a real-time environment, but in your desktop, we are not requiring that real-time communication. So, real-time operating systems are not of that requirement. Apart from this, the computer's booting time is quite more, and mobile operating systems booting time is quite less. So, that is why the architecture of mobiles is very different from that of the architecture of the computer systems. Apart from this, so far as the mobile architecture is concerned, there are key processors. Likewise, we are having a baseband processor, we are having application processor, we are having a processor for power consumptions, and we are having subscriber identity module, which that is SIM. So, these processors are having different roles so far as mobile architecture is concerned. The application processor is supposed to control the different application softwares, may be related to the display, may be related to the keypad, your power, your audio and video controls. Apart from this, so far as a baseband processor is concerned, they are supposed to deal with the radio signal communications, and power and audio processors are supposed to deal with the control of the microphones and your speakers and this. So, these are three processors which are fundamentally working. Apart from this, we are having subscriber identity module, SIM module, which is responsible for the communication of mobile device with the external world. In computer world, we are having instruction set computing. Instruction set computing is classified into two, that is complex instruction set computing and reduced instruction set computing. The complex instruction set computing is very much required. Here the instruction sets are complex and they are very much required in operation of normal computer. But the reduced instruction set computing is very much comfortable with the ARM architecture and it is required in your mobile devices. Apart from this, the complexity lies in the compiler in a reduced instruction set computing, whereas the complexity lies in a micro program in a complex instruction set computing. That means you require more number of lines of codes in reduced instruction set of computing. After every point of time, you need to have a communication. So that's why reduced instruction set computing is actually working in a mobile environment. Now, in a mobile, we are having different hardwares. The mobile hardware and the mobile operating systems are entirely different from that of the traditional conventional computer systems, because the mobile hardwares are required to have less power consumption and they should be plug and play. Now, in order to plug and play the mobile hardware, we are requiring a fundamental hardware base, that is the motherboard. So, motherboard is actually a hardware chip. We can say that it is SOC, you can say that it is system on chip. It is the hardware, it is the chip where we can assemble, we can connect different hardware components, likewise camera, we can connect memory components, we can go for n number of sensors, we can go for Bluetooth module can also be connected. So, you can connect different devices to this hardware chip, that is your motherboard, and which is in fact SOC, that is system on chip, and this will help you to configure different type of hardware. If you are having different sensors, if you are having different hardware component, be it camera or your Bluetooth communication module or whatever, and SOC, and there are GPIO pins, that is general purpose input output pins, and you are supposed to do a bit of programming. Hardly, it is very simple, it is not that difficult. Maybe in 4 or 5 line of codes, your device will be capable to communicate with the hardware. That is, system on chip is in fact an integrated circuit that integrates all the components of electronic environment, and to make those electronic environment components communicate with one another, we are supposed to go for the normal programming. The system on chip is not only limited to your mobile devices, be it any hardware. Likewise, you may have your DVD players, you may have your smart washing machines, you may have your smart air conditioners. So, they need some hardware component to integrate all other circuitries, and this facility is provided by SOC. There are different companies which are developing SOCs, likewise Qualcomm is there, Broadcom is there, and we are having Intel also developing SOCs. So, different companies are contributing to different SOCs. So, SOCs are further classified into SOCs for pervasive computing and SOCs for mobiles. So, likewise for pervasive computing, we are having Intel Quark and Broadcom. But Qualcomm and Snapdragon, they are very much famous SOCs for your hardware, in fact, for the mobiles.
So, sir, here my question would be, how do we integrate various mobile hardware components to the SOC?
This is a very good question. SOC is in fact a chip, it is in fact a motherboard that integrates different components. We are having different GPIO pins over there. We are having, so far as those who had worked with ICs, integrated circuits, they might be aware of that we are having a VCC signal, we are having ground signal, and we are having general purpose input output pins are there. We are simply supposed to plug in the bus at one end of the GPIO of SOC, and the other end of the bus is a belt of cables, tiny cables. That bus is to be connected to the device. Likewise, if I want to connect a camera, one end of the bus is supposed to connect with the GPIO pins and other end is supposed to be connected to the cameras. Apart from this, we are having a Bluetooth modules. Bluetooth modules are generally used for the communication purpose, and we can directly integrate a Bluetooth module. A small chip is there and with the help of the connecting wires, we can directly connect a Bluetooth module with the SoC chip, as a result of which we can have a Bluetooth communication. So, apart from this, we are having the GPRS and GSM modules are also available. Now, on the same lines of action, we can incorporate the GSM and GPRS modules directly, we can insert it into the allotted slots, or we can connect it with the help of the cables. Belt is tiny, small belt is available, because we are supposed to keep into mind that mobility is prime requirement. So, if we are wasting a lot of space with the help of due to wires, then it is of no use. So, connectivity should be very much strengthened. Apart from this, we are having sensors also. Likewise, we are having accelerometer, magnetometer, gyrometer. These are some of the sensors which are inbuilt. The inbuilt means that we can incorporate these sensors, these hardware modules, which can directly communicate with the GPIO pins of the SoC, that is the system on chip, which is an integrated circuit, and they directly communicate, they gather the data and provide the data to the mobile, which can be stored into the respective memories and can be processed by the ARM processor. So, data gathering. Likewise, if we are having an accelerometer and we are going on a walk, or we are using it in a car and we are going on a road, then at run time the accelerometer may collect the data that how many bumps their car has felt across the road, and they may go on the decision that what is the quality of the road. So, apart from this, touch phones, nowadays in the laptops also we are having touch screens. So, in smartphone we are having touch screen. So, what is in fact a touch screen? It is a capacitive screen. So, when we are putting our finger onto that screen, then the capacitance of that particular area is reduced, because of the finger pressure, the thickness of the plates in between the capacitor is reduced, as a result of which the voltage is changed, and because of that voltage fluctuation, the device is able to detect that in which zone, in which area of this screen the voltage is changed, and accordingly that particular application is invoked. So, this is how intelligently mobile hardware is supposed to work with your system on chip. That is the thing. There are, in fact, apart from this, we are having different memories, we are having SD cards. So, we can directly insert our SD cards into the, but if you realize that in a computer environment, we are having big hard disks. We are supposed to open the CPU, we are supposed to connect it with the help of the wires, then only we can use it. Apart from this, we are having flash memories which are plug and play. The same flash memory mechanism can also be used with the mobile devices. So, mobile devices are quite flexible, their hardware component are actually facilitating the mobility. We can plug and play the hardware devices, and these hardware devices are quite comfortable and compatible with the mobile operating system. The mobile operating systems are again the embedded operating systems with the add-on advantage of higher communication capacity. So, that means they are having a better networking feature. That means the mobile hardwares and mobile operating systems are quite different from that of the computer hardwares and the computer operating systems. This is what I would like to say about the computer hardwares.
Thank you so much, Dr. Siddhant Sharma, for such enlightening presentation about various mobile hardware components and their basic technologies. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Fauzia.